Hello and welcome you all again on this platform of KTHM e-learning. In the earlier lecture, we have discussed the concept of unemployment, poverty and regional imbalance. We have also understand the causes, effects and remedies of these three types of concept. And now in this lecture, we are going to study the concept, effects, causes and remedies of social injustice. After that, we will study the meaning, sources, effects and measures of black money. And lastly, we will understand the concept, problems and remedies of lack of technical knowledge and information. So, let's start with the concept of social injustice. Friends, social injustice can be described as a situation in which dominant population is made known of the inequality that leads for others due to their relative position in the structure of power. Social injustice occurs in a situation where the equals are treated unequally and the unequal is treated equally. Three common examples of social injustice include discrimination, ageisms, and homophobia. The social injustice is a situation when some unfair practices are being carried in the society. Whatever unjust is happening is usually against the law and it might not be something that is considered a moral practice. It occurs in a situation where the equals are treated unequally and unequal is treated equally. Okay, now let's see the effects of social injustice. First is, it reduces confidence level of entrepreneurs. Making social contacts is a necessity to become successful entrepreneurs. Where social injustice exists, building social contact is not so easy. Second is, unfair redistribution of resources. Financial resources and other resources are most essential for the growth of entrepreneurship. They are not equally distributed among all the sections of the society where social injustice prevails. Then third is, unequal access to opportunities and rights. Women are not given equal treatment. They always face greater difficulties when trying to balance work and family. Their parents do not equally share family responsibilities among all others. Although women are an integral part of the economy in any given society and state, women are still not being treated equally and are not offered equal opportunities in entrepreneurship. Women are still being treated as cheap labor and are regarded as inferior to men. Next is, unfair system of law and due process. Social injustice is immoral and criminal in nature. The legal system needs to be fair. The process of providing justice should be responsibly fast. It is necessary to punish the criminals who support and practice social injustice. The legal action must be taken in time so that the victim of social injustice recovers and gains the opportunity. In the absence of a good legal system, social injustice remains uncured. This creates problems for entrepreneur growth. And last is, increases unemployment. Due to social injustice, some people may not get jobs since they are capable to do the same. Now let us see or understand the causes of social injustice. So the first is population. Large population has always been the root cause of many problems. Social injustice is one of them. Next is unemployment. Unemployment leads to inequality of income in society. Besides corruption and political inferences, thus leads to social injustice. Next is underdeveloped infrastructure in rural areas. This leads to low level of economic growth in rural areas and widen the gap between rural and urban sector and leads to social injustice. Now next is inequality in distribution of land holdings. Zamindari system has been responsible for inequality in land distribution and income in India, which prevails even at present. And last is low female literacy rate. There is a wide gap between male-female literacy rates. As per census of 2001, illiteracy in any section of society gives rise to social injustice. Now, let's move to the next slide. Let's understand the solutions or remedies for social injustice. So, the first solution is education. Friends, investment in early education can increase economic mobility, contribute to increased productivity and decrease inequality. Next is work on your own habits and beliefs. To bring reforms in society, we need to work on our own habits and beliefs. Next is research the local presence. Research on the local presence is vital while formulating policies for the eradication of social injustice. Next is planned development. Planned development and introduction of basic facilities to all sections of the society plays a vital role in bringing equality. Next is increase the minimum wage. In that, higher wages has the potential to help people out of poverty. Increasing the minimum wages does not hurt employment, nor does it retard the economic growth. And last is builds asset for working families. Policies that encourage higher savings rates and lower the cost of building assets for working and middle class households can provide a better economic security for struggling families. Now, next, come to the next concept, black money. Let us see the concept black money. Friends, parallel economy is economic activity that is not taxed, regulated or monitored by the government. It is also called as the informal economy. Underground economy or the economy which generates black money. Black money is a money earned through any illegal activity controlled by country regulations. Black money proceeds are usually received in cash from underground economic activity and as such are not taxed. So the black money is money on which tax is not paid to the government. A store that accepts cash for its merchandise and does not issue receipts to its customers will be transacting in black money as it would not pay tax on the unaccounted sale. Now let us see the sources of black money. So the first is real estate. Due to rising prices of real estate, the tax incidence applicable on real estate transactions in the form of stamp duty and capital gains tax can create incentives for tax evasion through underreporting of transaction price. Payment in cash to the contractor may create black money. Then next is bullion and jewelry market. The purchase allows the buyer the option of converting black money into gold and bullion, while it gives the trader the option of keeping his unaccounted wealth in the form of stock not disclosed in the books or valued at less than market price. Next source is financial markets transactions. IPO manipulation, rigging of markets such as use of shell companies. Next is public procurement. Public procurement has grown mainly over the years in volume, scale and variety as well as complexity. The Competition Commission of India has estimated total public procurement figure for India at around 10 to 11 lakh crore per year and provides ample scope of corruption due to rigged procurement process. Next sources of black money is non-profit organization. In that, taxation laws allow certain privileges and incentives for promoting charitable activities which are misused and manipulated, highlighted by FATF as well, used to park funds of corrupt politicians and businessmen. Next source is informal sector and cash economy. Cash transactions, large unbanked and underbanked areas contribute to the large cash economy in India. Next is trade-based money laundering. In that, distinguishing the proceeds of crime and moving value through the use of trade transactions in an attempt at legitimizing their illicit origins. Then tax havens. In that, tax havens are typically small countries with low or nil taxation for foreigners who decide to come and settle there. Strong confidentiality or secrecy regarding wealth and accounts, very liberal regulatory environment, and allow existence where an entity can easily be set up without indulging in any meaningful commercial activity and yet claim to be a genuine business unit merely by getting itself incorporated or registered in that jurisdiction. This makes them highly desirable location for multinational entities wishing to reduce their global tax liability. Next source is investment through innovative derivative instructions such as participatory notes, that is P notes. And last is Hawala. It is an informal and cheap method of transferring money from one place without using banks, etc. It operates on codes and contacts and no paperwork and disclosure is required. Now let's move to the next concept, that is effects of black money. First is dual economy. Friends, the increase in the amount of black money in India over a period of time lead to perpetual growth of economic dualism, which consists of parallel economy. Next effect of black money is underestimation. A large underground economy and growth of black income lead to underestimation of the true size and incorrect picture of the economy by the officially compiled national income data. Next effect is loss of revenue to the government. In that, black money is largely attributed to tax evasion. Its direct impact is the loss of the government revenue. Next is undermining the equity. When a government resorts to progressive direct taxation to maintain equity in the distribution of the tax burden, the tax evasion and growth of black money affect the very concept of social justice by not allowing the desirable reduction in inequalities in of income. Next is widening the gap between the rich and the poor. In that, growth of the black money causes regressive distribution of income in the society. When the black money grows faster, rich becomes richer and the poor become poor. Next point is measures or solution of black money. So the first major is raids. Income tax department has power to conduct raids on the premises of taxpayer or other individuals and seize the unaccounted income and wealth and take necessary legal actions against the tax evaders. Next is demonetization. Demonetization of currency could help to unearth the black money to a large extent. Demonetization may succeed in reducing the quantum of black money, but it cannot prevent the generation of black money altogether. Next is voluntary disclosure scheme. In that, the government may adopt the policy that those who voluntarily disclose their black income of the past of the taxation authorities will not be punished and penalties may be waived or minimized. Next is rationalization of controls. In that, since ill-devised controls are major causes of black money, it is essential to rationalize the control system, like easing the process of licensing. Next is taxation reforms. In that, India needs a reduction in marginal tax rates, simplification of tax structure, taxation laws, and improvement in tax administration. Next is vigorous prosecution. In that, it is recommended that the department should completely reorient itself to a more rigorous prosecution policy in order to instill respect for the tax laws in the minds of the taxpayer. Next comes is special bearer bonds. In that, special bearer bonds were introduced in 1981 and 1991 to drag black money into the treasury's coffer. It is advocated to unearth black money and was modified with time. And last is rewards and awards. To encourage the honest taxpayers and create a positive attitude in the minds of people towards the payment of tax. Now come to the last point of this chapter, that is lack of technical knowledge and information. Let's understand the concept of lack of technical knowledge and information. Lack of information, technology, skills cost most of the companies financially, socially, and politically. Lack of skills is the inability to perform according to the new technology in the systems. Inability to perform jeopardizes the productivity and success of the organization. Let's move to the problems of lack of technical knowledge and information. So the first is less production. Lack of knowledge of technology leads to the less production, which could have been more if handled skillfully. Then wastage of resources. Due to lack of knowledge of using technology, things went wrong, output is zero, and it also results in wastage of resources. Then next is reduce speed. Lack of knowledge of handling machines reduce the speed of production. Next problem is goodwill. When production is slow and low and slow, consistent wastage of resources takes place, the image of the company falls in the eye of customers, investors and stakeholders. And last problem is loss. Loss, low production, wastage of resources, low workload, image, all these factors affect the profit of the company and it is has to suffer losses. And now come to the last point of this chapter, remedies for lack of technical knowledge and information. So the first remedy is training. Providing training from time to time and upgradation of knowledge helps to gain technical knowledge and information. Then communication. Better communication among the employees can be fruitful to overcome any problem that occurs while handling new technology. Then next is user-friendly technology. User-friendly technology should be introduced which is easy to handle and easily adoptable. Next is skillful employees. Machine handling should be given to skillful workers in order to avoid wastage of resources and ensure speedy production. The next is supervision. A keen supervision is necessary over the workers while using machine or new technology to overcome the shortcomings of lack of technical knowledge and information. And last is thorough knowledge or complete knowledge. A thorough knowledge or complete knowledge is required of any technology and the processes that are involved in the production of goods and services. The knowledge about the legal requirements and whether the business fulfills and complies with all the requirements of the law, the information of the market and relevant information related to the competitors. Now here we are going to stop this lecture. Thank you.